Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everybody, my name is Dian Rafni Asman and my registration number is A1M218-069. In this video, I want to tell you about my topic, that's basic principle PIES. P stands for positive interdependence, I stand for individual accountability, E for equal participation, and S for simultaneous interaction. Cooperative learning, when properly implemented, is a powerful instructional approach resulting in a spectrum of positive outcomes. Notice the caveat, when properly implemented. When these basic principles are in place, cooperative learning consistently produce academic gains, improve race relations, develop social skills, educates for character, promotes self-esteem, enhances class climate, and foster leadership and teamwork skills. By asking 5 simple questions, we determine if PIES are in place. Okay, you can see on the slide. Are students on the same side? Does the task require working together? Is individual public performance required? Is participation approximately equal? What percent of students are overtly interacting at once? Okay, the first part principle is positive interdependence. This principle is divided into two, positive correlation and interdependence. Okay, positive correlations. The purpose of this point is the occurrence of a good correlation between students so as to produce excellent outcomes. It occurs when outcomes go up or down together, when they are positively linked. Your gain is a gain for me, my gain is a gain for you. This is a statement if the positive correlation can run successfully. Otherwise, if there is a negative correlation, the result is their success depends on the failure of another. They are on opposite sides. So, positive correlation structures outcomes so students hope and work for positive outcomes for each other. Okay, the next is interdependence. Interdependence is how the task is structured. Interdependence is a task designed in such a way that no one of us can do it alone, but we can do it by working together. We have to create a task where each person's contribution is necessary. The statement that can illustrate is your knowledge and contributions benefit all of us. So interdependence structures the task so students need to work together. Okay, the next principle is individual accountability. The responsibility of each individual is conducting cooperative learning is needed to achieve maximum results, so that there are 3 rules that must be considered by every student, namely the first, me before we, namely the efforts of each individual to create something first before being distributed to group members. Second, me during we, which is the process when students perform their respective assignments as set out in the group assignment. And the last is me after we, namely showing or submitting the results that students have done and evaluating in the form of test. Okay, next is next principle is equal participation. If students don't participate in the practice sessions, they will not learn as much or score as heck on tests. Participation has benefits for those who need and receive help as well as for who offer help. In addition, student characteristics affecting participation. First, personality types. Students are divided into two, extrovert students and introvert students. You already know that students who are introverted tend to be shy and find it difficult to participate. Next is achievement, success orientation, and self-esteem. Students who perform well in school often have a high self-esteem. Otherwise, students who perform poorly are much more likely to withdraw. Next, developmental appropriateness. If a task at the appropriate level of difficulty, students will participate. If not, participation will wane. And the last is cultural and language minorities. Language minority, students often lack the academic language required for success. Many feel uncomfortable participating in intimidating whole class situation. The teacher, aware of the importance of equalizing participation, is constantly asking her or himself, how equal is the participation in my class at this moment? There are several things that must be considered in creating equal participation, including turn-taking, time allocation, think time, rules, individual accountability, and role assignment. Okay, the last principle is simultaneous interaction. It is the most powerful tool we have for increasing active engagement, simultaneous interaction. Kagan defines simultaneous interaction as the percentage of learners overtly engaged at any one moment. This is an important definition because the percentage figure tells us clearly that a group of four will create more interaction than a group of five, and that pair work doubles active participation compared to square work or work in a term of four. There is nothing in the call for face-to-face interaction that tells us that a group of four is better or in terms of amount of participation than a group of five, or that pair work is better than square work. Without calculating the percentage of active participants at any one moment, the teacher might think that a group of five is as good as a group of five for promoting active, engaged interaction. In fact, in the same amount of time in the group of three, each student talks almost twice as much as in a group of five. So, the more students talk with each other, the more they will be engaged and the better they will learn. Okay, I think that's all. Thank you very much for your great attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.